cooking a healthy version of a chicken burger. I would like to think most of the stuff you would have in your food press, and the only thing you might have to buy is the chicken breasts. So I'll just go through the ingredients with you for what you would need for these. So half a cup of flour, it can be plain or self-raising, it doesn't really matter that much. 3 tablespoons of mayonnaise. I use Hellmann's, but you, because it's just, I know it's a good quality, but you can go with whatever you have in the press. Again, salt and pepper. I always like the sea salt and the fresh ground pepper. Tin of sweet corn. 1 red onion, which is sweeter than the white onion, so you'll find there's less of a tang in the burger. It just combines nicer. And I have my red onion finely chopped. I got lazy today, so I bought my cheese already grated, a nice cheddar cheese, and then I've cut the chicken up into little pieces. You don't want it too small, but you want it to be able to kind of fork-sized pieces. If you don't particularly like handling raw meat and you speak nicely to your butcher, he might cut it up for you. And then you just need to finish off by adding 1 large egg to the mix, which will make us a nice batter. So I'll very simply start adding everything to it. It takes about 5 minutes. This is one of my quick and easy dinners when the kids are going training and everywhere else and I'm always in a hurry. Add in my cheese, red onion. You can put in as little or as much as you like of this. Sweet corn. Now, I'm making a large amount because there's 5 adults in our house for dinner tonight, but you can reduce down this if you have a smaller number, or it freezes very nicely as well. Mayonnaise. Combine it all. Now with this mix, I'm actually going to add 2 eggs because I've done quite a large amount. And stir that up. We'll be adding our 1/2 mug of flour. Coming together quite nicely, and we don't want it too wet, we just want it so that it will keep the ingredients stuck together when we're cooking it. Now, there, I'm going to add my salt and pepper. Now, remember, your mayonnaise is already seasoned, so you don't want too much salt and pepper. You can always add more after. If you have a look here at the consistency of the mixture, it's not too wet, but at the same time, there is just enough moisture in it to hold it apart. So I'm going to just throw a few spoons on. I'll just cook 1 burger at the moment just to show you. And nice hot pan. You can hear the little sizzle. I have it nice and hot. I'm on a fairly decent sized burger. As I said, I have 5 adults in the house tonight, so I'll get a lot of burgers out of that. Into my nice shape, turn it up there just a little bit. We'll leave that cook then for about 4 or 5 minutes and then we'll flip it on the other side. I've cooked the burger for about 4 minutes on one side, and as you can see, it's a lovely golden color and the cheese is all crisped up in it. So I just flipped it over and I'll give it another 4, maybe 5 minutes on this side just to make sure it's well cooked through, and then we can serve it up. We're ready to dish up the burgers now, and I use the brioche buns. They're a slightly sweeter version than the regular burger buns. They're kind of a sweet French bread is what you call them. Little Aldi, Superquinn, they're all doing them now. Little iceberg lettuce, because it's nice and crunchy. Gives you a good crunch in with the burger. Bit tomato, cheese, whatever you happen to like. I just like to put a bit of colour in with it as well. We get our now. You'll see, even when I cooked it, I kind of made sure it was the size of the burger bun so that it fits in quite nicely. It's lovely and crisp and brown, not too overcooked. That's the cheese. All it could be a lovely crunchy set, and whatever sauce you happen to fancy. Mine like the burger sauce. And there is your dinner. And it can be served with sweet potato fries, ordinary baked potato if you like, or just on its own. Feed the whole family. Thanks for watching and see you next time.